One of the ongoing debates about consumer 3D printing is just how far it'll go. Sure, it's revolutionary, but can 3D printers really become as ubiquitous as 2D printers or Wi-Fi routers? So much so that we can all just download the products we need and print them at home, making shipping physical widgets around the world a thing of the past? I mean, is there really a future where even your mom has a 3D printer sitting on her desk? Well, I have news for you. The future might just be now, because there is a new generation of 3D printers aimed at people who have zero interest in actually learning about 3D printers. And in this video, we're going to put it to the test to figure out, is this finally a 3D printer your mom, grandma, or wife can use? Let's get into it. Before we dive in, a short background. If you're like me, you've been hearing about the earth-shattering potential of 3D printing for decades. And man, when they talk about it, they really, really sell it. You'll be able to print whatever you want at home instantly. Just order the files online and forget about shipping, warehousing, and all of that. And I mean, on the one hand, this isn't all that far-fetched. I mean, who would have thought that we would all have Wi-Fi routers, smart cleaning robots, and many of the other things that none of us actually know how to assemble or even maintain in our houses? Heck, 15 years ago, I had one of the early examples of a desktop vinyl plotter, and if you told me that in 2020, moms everywhere would be buying and successfully using Cricut desktop plotters to cut, engrave, and draw all sorts of craft projects at home, I wouldn't have believed you. And yet, while consumer 3D printing has really blown up in the last 5 years, the fact of the matter is, 3D printing, at least so far, definitely isn't accessible to everyone. In the worst case scenario, getting into 3D printing involves assembling, maintaining, troubleshooting, and fixing your machine every time it gets clogged or otherwise out of whack. But even in the best case scenario, 3D printing means learning a ton of new information, ranging from incredibly complex slicing software for novices to all the different properties of the different materials, best practices for actually getting stuff to print successfully. It's no wonder that we are nowhere near the days where your mom, grandma, or your young children have a 3D printer that they can use on their own. But what if all of that is about to change? Well, here's introducing the AnkerMake M5C. In this video, we're going to be checking out the new AnkerMake M5C, which AnkerMake was kind enough to send over in addition to sponsoring this video. And right out of the box, there are a few very surprising things about this printer. First of all, there's the overall look and build quality. This printer certainly feels more like a polished kitchen appliance than it does a hobbyist 3D printer like an Ender or a Prusa. The materials, the finishes, the fit, and just the overall construction are much more polished than many of the products that we've become used to. Then there's the speed. This printer keeps up with some of the latest and greatest hobbyist printers in terms of speed, despite being a Cartesian design, which I think will be a big selling point to people who've been put off from 3D printing by how slow it has been up until now. But all of that really pales in comparison to what I consider to be the major surprise with this printer. It's the first printer I'm aware of that can be exclusively controlled through a simple companion app. Sure, there are lots of 3D printers these days that come with a companion app. But with the M5C, the app and the printer are freestanding, meaning that if you want, you can do all of your downloading models, printing, and printer management all through the app. Of course, there is a desktop app with its own easy-to-use slicer that does include an easy mode for beginners. So if you want, you can import your own models, change parameters, and all of that. And if you do choose to do that, you'll have a very simplified experience that, to me, is very reminiscent of the software suites that came with both my Flux BMO and my Cricut Maker machines, both of which are targeted at non-tech-savvy users. But even if you don't want to use the desktop app, you don't have to. You can actually just use the iPhone or Android app and print out pre-sliced models to your heart's content. No more configuring a slicer, tweaking profiles, choosing between different web interfaces, or any of that if you don't want to. Now, admittedly, this printer is not yet launched at the time of recording, so the library of pre-sliced models is pretty limited. But I actually love this idea, and I would really like to see AnkerMake provide more models like this in the same way that Cricut provides hundreds or even thousands of pre-made projects to Cricut owners. Because I think that this is a great way to get people into the hobby and get them excited enough to actually learn more. I know. It's a huge departure from what we 3D printing enthusiasts are used to. But is it enough? Is this level of simplification enough to finally make 3D printing accessible to everyone? To find out, I enlisted the help of a real-life mom, Leah, who volunteered to try out the AnkerMake M5C with little to no guidance or help from me. I did make sure that this machine was fully assembled and functional beforehand because, let's be honest, you would do the same if you bought your mom a 3D printer as well. But from there, Leah was on her own. Here's what happened. I invited Leah, a real-life mom of two boys, more or less my age, to see how she gets along with the AnkerMake M5. Leah, you have no experience with 3D printing, do you?
None. Okay. Not even good with 2D printing.
Yeah, you were telling me you had an issue with your 2D printer that I need to help you with. But I think you might do okay with this, and I'm gonna be just off camera in case you need help, so have fun.
Okay, thanks. I want to say that my boys got me this as a present. It's really handsome and it's sleek and streamlined, but I have no clue how to use it. And I'm really not good at reading directions. And they left me here with this. Okay, so quick start guide. We're going to power on. Ready? This looks like the power on. Although it shows that it might be down here, but this, well, I don't know. I think this is power on. Okay, here we go. Power on.
No lights, no noises, but I guess we're on.
There's a computer app, which is more advanced.
Okay.
I'm gonna give you the iPhone app to get started.
Idle, status, control, 25 centigrade is a nozzle, heat bed. Okay.
So here you got food. I laid out some colors for you.
Oh my God, these are beautiful.
All the different colors.
Oh my God, this is so exciting. Wow, okay, I love the rainbow. Okay, let's start with rainbow. Look at all those beautiful colors. Yay! This one's also really pretty. Okay, so somehow we're loading this.
Yes.
Do we put it up here like this? Oh my God, I guess that was a good guess. Where's my directions? Okay, it looks really clear for any really brilliant person. They could do this in a minute. I just seem to be a little handicapped. Okay. So we're setting up the system. We are loading the filament. This is the filament. We have to open this. Okay. And it looks like there's two spots here that they might go in. Yeah, visually challenged. Oh, that's helpful. Oh, up here. Okay. There it is right in the picture that I don't look at. You'd think that it was Chinese or something, but it's not. It's so clear. Some of us are just not that visual, I guess. It's in the top. Where's my brilliant friend when I need her? Now we have to thread it, no?
Mm-hmm. You can push it all the way through.
Wow, this can go all the way through? Just keep going. Have faith.
Yep.
Okay.
When it stops,
why do my two children, my children, when they buy me these things, and then they don't explain how to use it, they're like, go ahead, Mom, you want to be part of the 21st century? So, get it. Oh, I think it's happening. No.
You have
extra extrude. Oh, I don't know that word. Okay, extrude. Is something gonna happen?
At this point, the son in me is feeling guilty that I'm not helping Mom out. All right, so it's heating up.
Okay, that's what's happening.
Yep.
As the
so
numbers.
You're all good.
Okay.
It's heating up, and then what's gonna happen is the plastic is going to come through, get melted, and come out like a hot glue gun.
Oh my God.
And then what's gonna happen, and this is the cool part, is it's gonna move this and this around and basically just draw you something.
Wow.
In 3D.
Okay. And that, now is that set up for me, what it's gonna draw?
So you have two ways that you can do. Here, you have a bunch of models that you can choose from, and you can print any of these.
Oh my God, I can't believe it.
And then if you want,
beautiful, yeah,
we can go on the internet and you can download any model you want and slice it on the computer and print it as well.
Okay, well, I like the pyramid.
All right, go for the pyramid.
Wait, let me check, there's so many. I like the pyramid.
Go for it.
But we want it colorful.
Yes, it's okay. Gonna come out all these rainbow.
Okay, gonna love it.
So you can just hit print.
Whoa, okay. Yeah.
And then,
do your print, yeah, it's going, printers.
And you can select your printer.
Anker, I can't believe I'm doing this off my phone.
And just hit print.
This is so great.
Yeah, so one of the big things is up until now, to use one of these, you had to use desktop software and you had to actually like configure all the parameters. And while this is heating up, I can kind of show you the software that they've given us.
Say,
you can tell me what you think, but basically you can take any model you download anywhere on the internet and drag it in there.
Wow.
And then you can just decide how you want to print it. And you hit slice and it will shoot it to the printer.
That's it?
Yeah, feel free to play around with the software and see what you think.
Okay.
And in the meantime, it's going to start printing this thing.
Okay. Well, so now what? Where would I find more models? Is that
Yeah, that is the great question.
What are you doing? What'd you do?
Printables. That's printables.com.
Okay. Okay. Let's print something down here. Yeah. Wow. I found one with a bee. It's called Bee and Honey Comb Suckle Slide Hair Clip. I like it.
This will take like 20, 30 minutes probably.
Okay, let's do it. And yeah. Plus it'll be really practical. I can use it. I love exactly. Things I can use.
Do you want me to find you some other color filaments?
Sure.
All right, I'm gonna go dig out, you want gold?
Is that gold or yellow? Yeah, gold would be good though.
You got it.
Fine. This will be great because then everyone's gonna ask me, where'd you get that? And I'll be like, I made it.
I printed it.
Oh, right, I printed it.
I'm kind of cheating and helping, but that's okay.
Are you kidding? I need the help. This is what I tell my boys. I love the help.
All right, so there's all your files. Okay. And you can arrange them however you want.
Okay, this is what, this one doesn't seem to move this easily. Here we go, now they're separate, right?
Now, we need to slice it. So, you have a parameter there called easy mode, which is really good. And if you want, you can just hit the slice button.
Okay.
And what that's gonna do is convert it into layers. So, basically give the printer instructions on how to print it piece by piece by piece.
Wow, this is pretty.
Isn't that cool? And you can scroll up and down and see exactly how it's gonna print it out.
Really?
Yeah. So you can just take that little white dot and drag it. We can try expert mode as well.
Oh, what's that?
I don't know. I don't use this software. This is like their beginner software, but it's pretty exciting to see what it can and can't do.
I'm really clueless about everything. So the fact that I can start to do any of this is pretty exciting. This is really amazing that someone who's as non-technological as I am. I remember in art school, I used to use those guns and I loved them. Yeah, so the fact that this can do it for me is even better. I don't have to get my hands all sticky and mushy. It's moving by itself. Oh my gosh, here we go. So if I wanted to like have a coffee while I'm doing this, I can. I don't, there's nothing I need to do to, just does it by itself. Oh my God, it's drawing the butterfly. Whoa, that's insane. Oh, and it goes over and over it. So first it comes out really thin, then it's nice and thick. Mmm. Says time left, 56 minutes and 41 seconds. That's incredible. So it takes an hour to make a beautiful hair accessory. Look at all that gold. Oh my God, it's so yummy. Wow, I can't even believe it. I don't believe I'm seeing this. This is like insane.
Bad news, friends. Unfortunately, this printer has clogged. And I wish I could say it was the first time, but unfortunately I think because it's a prototype, it's the third time that this machine has clogged. We did manage to salvage the hair tie, but it didn't print all the way. I'm gonna reach out to AnkerMake and see if they're still making improvements on the hot end. But unfortunately, this little experiment has ended.
However, I have a hair tie and I will wear it. And it's a butterfly with nice detailing. And eventually it'll be in my collection.
Well, there you have it. While the AnkerMake M5C might not be a 3D printer designed for us tech-savvy 3D printing enthusiasts who are seeking the ultimate level of customizability, performance, and flexibility, maybe, just maybe, it is the first printer that you can actually pick up for Mother's Day, safe in the knowledge that good old mom will actually be able to use it. And I don't know about all of you, but to me, that's pretty exciting. I mean, I already have a list of about 20 different things that my own mom wants me to 3D print for when she comes to town, and it would actually be really cool for her to be able to print as many of them as she wants at home without having to wait around for me to get it done. But hey, what do you think? Do you welcome this type of attempt to make 3D printing more accessible to everyone? Or are you a purist who fears that people really should learn the ropes in order to be able to enjoy the benefits? I'd love to hear in the comments below. Once again, let me thank AnkerMake for sponsoring this video. A huge thanks to Leah for bravely volunteering for the video. Thanks to my Patreon supporters who, by the way, do get early access to all sorts of secret projects like this and bonus content. And thanks to all of you for watching, liking, and subscribing. That's all for this week, but I'll see all of you on the next layer.